To Entrepreneur Journey, and my guest today is Stephen Bates, head coach of Certain Change and CEO of Certain Change. First of all, Stephen, tell us a little bit about you and your business.
Really good to be here. Thanks very much for inviting me on. It's a coaching business, but I've been coaching 20 plus years. It's not something I've just started doing because of COVID. So did I say that? So I've been doing it 20 plus years. My speciality is entrepreneurs. Really, though, the speciality is why do people get in their own way? My speciality is getting people who sabotage themselves, why they're not living up to their abilities, their skills. So my favorite thing is finding out why they get in their own way and getting that out of the way so they can achieve the results they could achieve. Now, it sounds very woolly, but I promise you it's not. I'm pretty direct and tough. Well, you know that. Have you been on the receiving end? Yeah.
So I have some rapid fire getting to know you questions.
Go on then.
Your favorite places you ever traveled?
I've been all around the world several times. I love traveling. But the place that surprised me the most, that just for some reason just got me, was Monument Valley.
Nice.
And I've been all over the place, but Monument Valley, I loved it.
Where haven't you been that you want to go?
So many. Alaska. I want to go to South America a bit more. I want to actually travel in Japan a bit more because I went to Japan, but I did martial arts when I was much younger, and we just stayed in the local area. All Africa, definitely Africa. I want to go to Africa. I've only touched the top bit of Africa. I've never been through into Africa. So
I've always wanted to do a safari.
So yeah,
that'd be really cool.
Yeah,
awesome. And do you prefer coffee or tea?
Neither. Can't stand either.
Really? Wow. What do you do for energy? What do you do for just to get up and go?
Well, I always tease everybody who needs coffee because I say I don't need the caffeine hit. Because my body's doesn't need it. So it's like, I'm all right. I've got my own motivation. And when I need to crash, I'll just take a break. I'll lie down on the sofa in my office and have a snooze. And then, so yeah, I for me, the big thing about where's a decent coffee and what's the best coffee and all the different flavors, it's just like a whole different thing to me.
Yeah, I didn't start drinking coffee till I was 30. And I just recently am trying to quit it. I switched to tea. So, I'm trying to wean myself off of coffee. So it's going pretty good so far. No headaches, anything like that. So. Cool.
I blame my parents because I always had to make coffee for them when I was a kid. Mm. I never wanted to drink it, but I don't drink hot drinks at all. So never. So
awesome. What is something that annoys you?
My brain went professionally. I call it the psychobabble world. When people are taught concepts and ideas with no practical way of changing it. So this is the bit people are always working on changing, but they're never actually shown what it is to resolve something. And there's a lot of people who will teach. And I think I've earned the right to call it fluff, but they teach the fluff and they don't know what to do with it. And it holds people back more than is necessary because they learn the concept and they think they've got the answer, but actually, it's like marketing, isn't it? So it's like saying to somebody, this is organic. This is organic marketing.
Right. Okay.
What do you do with it?
Right. Yeah.
So I'm a very practical point person from it comes to I don't even like the word mindset. I suppose that it's become too fluffy. I just like to call it what it is, thinking or good thinking.
Right.
Rather than what you marketeers have done with it. Calling
it mindset. Well, I try and do things a little differently than a lot of marketers.
Yeah, well, I know.
Okay, so you're on a deserted island. What is the one thing you take with you and who is the one person you have with you?
I'll take my wife.
Of course.
Yeah. Do other people choose other people?
I'm just starting to ask this question, but I really want to keep asking it because I want to know some of these interesting answers that I may get. So.
Okay. Well, I was thinking about this and I mentioned, I was thinking about this and thinking, okay, what was it I would, if I'm going to take my wife, what else would I want? And actually, the answer is boxing gloves. And I'm not sure my wife would actually agree with this. But this is not how you think it is, actually. Okay. This is not how you think it is. The boxing gloves are for her and the mitts are for me. Okay? Because I used to do a lot of martial arts. She loves boxing, but she doesn't want to fight anybody, but she loves the boxing training. She loves being fit. She loves doing exercise. And to be on an island, as long as it's with sun, she will love it. But when she needs to get up and do something, she wants to, yeah, she likes playing, she likes sparring, she likes having a bit of fun. She's so for my own sanity, she needs to punch out the gloves a little bit once in a while. So as long as she's happy, I'm happy. So so that's why it's, but I think she would have picked gin to go with her on the island. But for me, my sanity is that she needs the boxing gloves and I need the mitts.
Nice. I love that answer. So now I have a few questions about your particular entrepreneur journey. Tell us a little bit about your journey and up to this point in your business.
Okay, so this is something that I think about a lot, but when I first started my first business was 26-27 years ago. And I started a physiotherapy business. But it wasn't. It was just me employing myself in my own job because I couldn't scale it. Mm-hmm. So I became a very successful solopreneur, but I couldn't scale it. And I had a millionaire who came to me once and he just said, I know how much you earn and you will never adjust it because you are limited by time. And that's for the first time, even though I've been running the business for probably 5-6 years and I was doing well. I mean, I started from where I was to having this business. I had a great job, my own time. I could do when I wanted. I was earning way more money than I ever had been. And I thought that was a business, but it wasn't. I'd employed myself in my own job, but as a successful solopreneur. And then he came along and just introduced me to the concept of being an entrepreneur. So my entrepreneur journey wasn't, even though I started my business, I wasn't even an entrepreneur because I didn't even know what the hell that was. Because my parents, my mum was a teacher, my dad was a policeman. There was nobody who did business. I had no education, but I had the drive of an entrepreneur, but I had absolutely no guidance. I don't even knew what the name was, to be honest, the word was. So the entrepreneur journey into where I am now, and a lot of people are like, you were a physiotherapist. How do you end up coaching entrepreneurs and coaching CEOs and all sorts of things? And it's because my speciality was when I was a physio, I noticed a lot of people who I was working with in real physical pain, couldn't pick up their kids, couldn't go to work, paying me money, had to take time off. Their lives were wrecked by their body not working. When I said to them, just do some stretches, stop doing this. And this is back when people used to pay to have people come and look at their desks to find if the computer's in the right place. That's how long ago it was.
Wow.
Yeah. When I told them this, about 40% of people just wouldn't do it. They forgot, or I was busy. So I got really puzzled the fact that if you're in that much acute pain, real physical pain, and you're still sabotaging your own recovery, what is going on? And that's when my brain flipped from being a physio into why do we think this way? And that really has taken me down a pathway over the last 20 years, exploring this, working with this. And I've worked in all sorts of different niches and trained all sorts of coaches in different niches. So I train coaches as well and understanding this. And I just love working with entrepreneurs because entrepreneurs have to get up and go to move forward. But a lot of them have this sabotage thinking. So they end up in a lot of conflict. And I love helping people get rid of that conflict so they can then move forward fast because they can do it, but they won't let themselves. Right. So it all came back from why are people not letting themselves heal physically?
Yeah. So many people could use that kick in the butt that you give them.
Yeah.
So tell me a time when you struggled in your business and how you broke through that.
Oh, loads of times. and marketing was my one. Because when I started as a physio, I was I say physio, but I always studied other things from Japan and different methods, and I got really busy really fast. So the most I had to do was put an advert in the Yellow Pages, and that was it, because there wasn't anything else anywhere. There was no internet. Right. And people used to phone me up, but mostly it was referrals. So it wasn't until I started working with other people and I got referrals doing the mindset stuff, the coaching stuff, that I thought, well, actually, do you know what? I need to tell people about this, because a lot of people I work with, they don't want to tell anybody that they've come to see me because they're too embarrassed.
Mm.
Yeah. The amount of conversations I have with people.
Talk about the wrong thinking. I think that's the wrong thinking.
Yeah, it is. And it's, they don't want to say anything to anybody, because and I had a call with someone today, and on the surface, they project this, I'm okay. Inside, they are falling apart. And that's really common. So I had to do this marketing thing. I didn't have a clue. And then I hired some people who I thought knew marketing, but they were just going to design me a website and give me a new colors on my business cards. Mm-hmm. And I was a rookie. I had no idea, no business training. So I got stung a few times. I also had my own thing. I even had a book called How to Be a Little Bit Famous. So I could be famous, but not. So that was my conflict. So I've done it too. Okay. And the breakthrough really was, it's okay for me to be out there, because I wasn't going to harm my family by being famous. And I wasn't, and I was good enough. I was good enough to be out there. So there was a mental thing, and then learn how to be better at marketing. I still don't like marketing. I still don't like it. I like doing the work.
Yeah. So tell me what an ideal day as an entrepreneur looks like for you.
Ideal day is just seeing people succeed for me, and signing more people up so I get my money proof, and I can do what I want for my life and my family, and do the things that are, you know, fun and important and everything else. So it's just a combination of punching the air because someone believes in me to sign up, and then I know I can help them. So I get the fun of, yeah, okay, the money's going to go in the bank, but it's that, yes, I could get to help somebody else.
Yeah.
And then,
yeah. Sorry, didn't mean to interrupt.
No, please.
No, I was going to say, it's the same thing for me. I love to help other businesses. Well, like when our marketing, what we do for them helps grow their business, that's what gets me excited. The money comes because you. I like to say relationships and results equal revenue. So if, as long as you do have good relationships and can have the results, your revenue is going to be there. So,
And that goes back to answering the question about the breakthroughs. The marketing was the thing I needed to be better at so I can help more people. And that's why I love training coaches. I train coaches who their programs, they have the clients who come through their programs and they don't know why they fall off their programs, because other people have gone through their programs and got great results and other people just disappear. So I want to help more people get better results because they're a happy person. They go home happy to their family. They spend more time with their kids. They have more money to do the things, but they employ more people. So that's the impact side of it. So in my day, it's a combination of, yeah, we've got a new person, and it's the client work. I love doing the client work, and I love it when they phone up and say, I've done this. I had a conversation with somebody, first conversation, very next day they changed their behavior and they brought in a 4-figure sum that they wouldn't have had.
Nice.
Just them understanding how they were thinking and then changing their mind and saying, this is silly. And then they acted completely differently and they had a 4-figure sum they got in just because they decided to do something differently. But the impact on them is fantastic.
So speaking of clients that you work with, what are the top three things that you see them struggle with?
Well, entrepreneurs, there's only two things that entrepreneurs really need to focus on. And anything that's interesting in really is money, because they're creating a business. Okay, so the money is the thing that they want to achieve and have, because we need it in the physical real world. But it's also as a testament of I've done a good job. Entrepreneurs are motivated really by one thing. I did this. Mm-hmm. I made it happen. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's why we like it. We go, I'm going to set myself a crazy goal and find out how to do it and go, I did this. And the money and all the trappings are the evidence that we did it. So it's the money. But then with the money, when the money comes, there's usually a conflict with time. So how do you have money and time?
Right.
And each, I call it the entrepreneur superhighway. And there's five levels. Shall I go through that? Is that okay? Have we got the time?
Yeah.
So there's five levels of the what I call the entrepreneur superhighway. And the first level is worker. So you are an entrepreneur at heart, but you're being paid by somebody else in a job and you want to get out. So it's making that leap from being a worker to being what I call a solopreneur. And a worker has no control of time and their money is capped. They're told what to do and they're told what they're worth. And the entrepreneurs hate that. So they have the ambition to move forward. And then to be a solopreneur, the trouble with a solopreneur is if they do really well, they have a good business, they're working on their own, they run out of time. And that's when they get really stressed and they work too many hours and they don't see their kids, they feel guilty. So it's how to then make the move to be a business leader. And business leader, it's about how to leverage the time and the resources of others to grow your money. So it's always a money time thing. At the fifth level is business owner, when you can step out completely and you get all of your time to do with what you want and have the money. Yeah. So each one is a different process. But back to your question, what gets in the way is, first one is this thinking, this belief system. Can I do this? Am I smart enough to do this? Do I deserve this? What can I charge? Will people buy it? What happens if I get criticized? So this is the mindset stuff that people don't get is so important, because your thinking dictates every action you take. We don't do anything without thinking about it. Right. But a lot of entrepreneurs, they're human beings. They grew up being told that they can't, they're not good enough, they're not smart enough, they failed in their exams. A lot of entrepreneurs fell out of school without good, because they were just the wrong temperament for that sort of system. So that's the first thing. And then it's the how do you make sure that you're doing the right things and have the right thinking for each level from worker. And I mentioned four because the one you don't want to hit, which is number two, which is entrepreneur, when you're spending all your time working hard and getting no money. You've lost all your time and you have no money. That's the worst place to be.
Might as well go back and have a job, right?
Yeah, and that's what a lot of people do, and they hate it, but that's where they can get the money. So this is where it's a balance of the right thinking for the right level with the right skills at the right time. And so that's what I do with people.
That leads me to my next question. What advice would you give someone that feels like they are stuck in their business right now?
Look at why you're stuck. And what we tend to do is we want to look at the stuff that is the easy stuff to look at, not the stuff we need to do. What is the thing that we don't want to do? Because we all in business, I think there's only three what I call attitudes. And I call it the genius zone. I know other people use the term genius zone, but people are naturally innovators. They like to create. They're natural managers who like to control, or they're workers who like to do. And they're the only three. But this is not about your skills, because we can do all of them. But it's the what do we love doing? And if you're spending what time you love doing, I'm a creator, or I'm a controller, or I'm a worker who loves to do, we get our satisfaction. So you can't do all three, because we have a first preference, a second preference, and the third one is the one we really don't like doing. So if we're not looking at what we don't love to do, or what we're scared of doing, or what we're fearful of doing, if we don't clear that out of the way, we can never really be good at what we do and spend most of our time doing what we love to do. So, but each level, as I said, is slightly different in terms of what you need in terms of skills. So the first thing is, if you are not doing something which is critical, people call it procrastination. procrastination is a natural part of making good decisions. You're meant to stop and doubt before you sign on the dotted line. Because otherwise your enthusiasm or your fear will just have an idea and you'll just go and do it. And then you wonder why you did it later. You go, that's not a good idea. Buyer's remorse. So we're meant to stop and go, am I sure? Let's just think this out and stop and get out of the emotion and just be critical. So we're meant to lose our confidence. We're meant to have doubts. We're meant to have a little bit of fear just to make a stop and go, yeah, it's a good idea. Let's go. Or let me go and think out this plan again before I do it. When that extends into never doing what you should be doing, that's when you've got this sabotage thinking, this sabotage loop mindset. And if you don't clear that out of the way, you'll always be stuck in it. And a lot of people get stuck moving from one to the next level, or they're stuck in their belief that about what they deserve. So they'll never put their prices up, or they'll never grow their business and actually hire teams, or they will never move from worker to be a solopreneur. They're always planning it and thinking about it, but they never let themselves do it, even if they have the skills.
Awesome. So since we are a marketing agency, I do have some marketing questions for you.
Yeah, go for it. I'm not sure I'm the right person to ask.
Well, it's just your take on marketing. Do you, I think you already answered this. Do you enjoy marketing, or just feel like it's a necessary thing that you have to do?
It's a necessary thing I have to do, which I love marketing when I get a result.
Awesome.
I don't like it.
Yeah. You know, it's all about results. You can hire lots of different marketing people that can do ads and websites, but a lot of times they just put you an expensive paperweight on the internet and you get no results. It's very important to vet who's going to do your marketing for you. So also tell us a little bit about ways that you market your business.
Mainly organic at the moment. I'm doing a bit of a rebrand and a rethink and a restructure. So mainly it's organic because people, they need to trust me. They need to, because we're talking about stuff that scares the living daylights out of them. It's them looking at themselves and going, I failed. I don't want to look at that. So they have to trust me. So it's mainly, I like to show people why they haven't allowed themselves to do what they could do. This is what I've been doing the last 25 years. And when people understand it, they go, oh, that makes sense. That's silly. It doesn't work, does it? And then they just change their mind and then they go, okay, let's explore. So it's usually when people understand that I understand them, I understand their problem. And this is the usual, most of the time they see something 2, 3, 5, 7, 10 times, and then they go, do you know what? I'm going to pluck up courage and let's have a call. So that for me seems to be the recipe. And obviously there's many ways of doing it, but it does come down for me. It's just, I think they just got to realize I know what I'm doing and what I'm talking about more than, and then understand their problem.
So just to follow up on that, this really wasn't in the questions that I had. Do you feel like, because there is a time investment in doing this organic marketing, do you feel like the ROI on organic for you is really good?
Yeah, it can be. When the more skillful I've got at it, and the more advice I've taken on it, you know, I'm a coach. If I don't take advice as a coach, and I shut off from taking advice as a coach because I got bad advice and I got money taken away from me. But when I take good advice, and I test it out, then it is worth it. There's things I want to do to leverage, so I'm not doing most of it most of the time. But this is a very personal thing for a lot of people, so I've got to be involved in it. But good systems, you know, to me, it's I like systems, but people, you know, you need to have that experience, and then let's make the systems work well to leverage it. So that's what I'm getting better at. That's what I know I need to get better at.
And that's how we help people too with the organic. We help them put in systems as well as the way that they need to be doing organic, because a lot of people go about it the wrong way. So,
And the thing in the marketing thing is, you know, someone like you come into someone like you, you make my life so much easier. But my problem was I wouldn't come to someone like you, because I've been burnt by people who, and not disparage designers, but I didn't know the difference between a designer and a marketing systems person. And you need both, and they need to join up, and they need to have a purpose, and it needs to be tested. But I'm not sure you're going to like this, but in economics, they call, there's a saying about economics being the dismal science, and marketing is almost like the dismal practice of business for a lot of people. And because if you liked, human beings like certainty, human beings like to be sure before they take a step, which is good luck because that's not the real world. And
right.
And actually, human beings, we forget this, human beings like excitement and new, unique things and variety, spice of life. So people think, human beings don't like certainty. You know, we want certainty in everything. That's not true. We like to go to different places. And you ask me the question about where do you want to travel? So we do like it, but when we feel like we're in control of it. And with marketing, a lot of business people, I think, don't feel in control of it. And they feel they're handing over to control to an agency, and they can't. So
which goes back to the relationship and results.
Exactly.
So
my job as the boss of my own company is to not abdicate responsibility to you. It's to delegate the things you're better at than me. But I don't give up responsibility for the results of my own marketing. And I promise you, I always wanted to give it to somebody else. And that's when my marketing wasn't very good.
Nice. Well, Stephen, it has been a pleasure having you on the Entrepreneur Journey today. I hope the rest of your day is amazing. Thank you once again.
My pleasure. It's really been good. It's been great to chat. All right. Thanks a lot.
All right. Bye.